wearing the black and white. His professional record on...
Undefeated, lightweight contender, 18-0 with 15 knockouts, only 21 years old is Ryan Garcia. Ryan Garcia says the best two lightweights in the division are Lomachenko and Devin Haney. When asked about Teofimo Lopez and Richard Comey, he says those two are not really that good. I expect to fight those guys down the road. Garcia is scheduled to fight Avery Sparrow on September 14th, this Saturday night. Garcia is a big favorite, as Avery Sparrow has no power to keep the heavy-handed Garcia off of him. I expect a great showing for Ryan Garcia in this fight. And The Zone has big things for Ryan Garcia. They think he'll be the next superstar in boxing. In other boxing news, Bobby Arum said after the Lomachenko-Campbell fight that Lomachenko might fight in December. Now that seems that's not the case. Lomachenko won't fight again until a unification match against Teofimo Lopez or Richard Comey. Means you might be looking at March or April when you see Lomachenko again. Lomachenko is 14-1, and the next time he gets in the ring, he'll be 32 years old. My question to you, will Lomachenko surpass 20 wins? Now, I'm not knocking him. He's a three-division champ with those 14 wins. That's impressive. I also got him behind Crawford and Canelo in the pound-for-pound list. Lomachenko's manager said it's more than likely Lomachenko's gonna sit out for the rest of the year and wait for the Richard Comey and Lopez fight and see who the winner is of that. And say the soonest he can fight is probably March. Unless some big offer that comes up overseas, then Lomachenko might take that fight. But more than likely, Lomachenko is done for the year. When you look at Comey and Lopez, who would be the tougher matchup for Lomachenko? Some experts compare Richard Comey to Luke Campbell. There are similarities. Both got a 71-inch reach. Good jab. Both do not like body shot. They do not like being hit to the body. Luke Campbell's a southpaw. Comey's conventional, and I think he hits harder than Campbell does. I think Comey uses his height a little bit better, and if Comey lands that right hand, I think he seriously can hurt Lomachenko. I also think Lomachenko's punch placement can hurt Comey. Now you're looking at Teofimo Lopez. Before the Nakatani fight, everybody thought this guy's a superstar waiting to happen. But after the Nakatani fight, you have experts coming out, well, maybe he's not that good. Maybe he's overhyped. But all the greats, not saying Teofimo Lopez is great yet, but you look through history, all the greats had fights like this. Ali didn't look good against Ken Norton. That's one example. I mean, they all have fights like this. Now, we know Teofimo Lopez has power, but we don't know what his weakness is as far as can he take a punch or does he take a body shot well. I think the Lomachenko fight will see what Teofimo Lopez is made of. Can he take a punch to the body? Can he take it to the chin? Teofimo Lopez shows great power too, but I think what ultimately would do him in this fight is experience. Championship rounds, going against a masterful boxer. So what's your opinion? Who would give Lomachenko a tougher fight? Richard Comey or Teofimo Lopez? Leave your thoughts and comments below. Jay Beezy. Subscribe to the channel. I'm out.